Now let us go to the section 3, and in this section we are going to consider the irrationality of a given number. I mean, the given number, how to prove the given number is irrational, we are going to study in this section. Irrational numbers. To prove the given number to be irrational or not, the following theorem is helpful. And let us recall the definition of irrational number. A real number A is said to be irrational if it can't be expressed in the form P by Q with Q not equal to 0. And some examples of irrational numbers are root 2, root 3, root 5, root 3 by root 2, 1 plus root 3, 0.101, 2 zeros, and 1000030, and so on and so forth. At each stage, 10 is occurring here. That number is also irrational number. To prove the numbers root 2, root 3, root 5, etc. are irrational number, the following theorem is helpful. The intended theorem is let P be a prime number. If P divides A square, then P divides A, where A is a positive integer greater than or equal to 2. And the proof is like this. Let the prime factorization of A be A equal to P1, P2, P3, etc. into Pn, where P1, P2, etc. are primes and need not be distinct the numbers. And therefore, I can write down this as A square equal to P1 into P2 into P3, etc., etc., Pn, and that into P1, into P2, into P3, etc., etc., Pn by prime factorization theorem, that equal to P1 square, P2 square, into P3 square, so on and so forth, Pn square. And now, by the fundamental theorem of arithmetic, this is unique representation, and only primes are P1, P2, P3, and Pn. As it is given that P divides A square implies that P is a factor of A square. That means some pi that is in one, I can say in one, in one must be p. Without loss of generality, assume that P1 equal to P. You may assume P2 is equal to P, or even at the end Pn is equal to P, because one of the pi must be P. and therefore a square is equal to p into p2 into p3 into so on so forth into pn into p into p2 into p3 into so on so forth pn, and therefore a equal to p into p2 into p3 so on so forth pn. What it shows, a has a factor p, a has a factor p, and that is a has a factor p. Therefore p divides a, that is I can write symbolically p divides a. This is what exactly we wanted to prove in the theorem.